Well, here it is. It's Olympics time. So every matchup has to be U.S. versus world, except for the final three. It can be whatever it has to be. We start on the 5-4-4. Their version of the Great Wall is on the left. Last tournament. He's taken up by Tony in the first round. He's taken up by Sam. So, yeah. Forward for Tiff. Lucky duck. She got that one spot. It's big cup. By the way, first three holes, this does count towards the tournament, like the year tally. Ooh, he went a little too far left. Tiff will probably spot that and go center. Nope, she hit one in that nut. Yeah, she hit the water, so she's out. Alright, our second Olympic matchup with the T-Bone and Regis. T-Bone, last tournament, got shocked by Emma in the first round. Regis, in chaos in the first round. 5-5. 5-5, this should be T-Bone, obviously. So yeah, they said the Olympics will have big hole, because, you know, not a bad idea. Regis then beat Falcon in a playoff. And he went to the final six, but Maya took him out. Now the question is, do you go for it or not? I think the consensus is that you basically go around. Yeah, I think they're going to do the smart thing and go around. Yeah, you got to do the smart thing, go around. Because if you hit this hit out of bounds, basically, it gives the hole to the opponent. And there's no shame in trying to sink like an 8-iron.
There's nothing you can do.
You won't. Champion. However, he also took out the defending Supercross champion, that being Falcon, before the final. So that means that Regis picked up an extra point. He got 6 in total. He almost touched it. Well, Regis could definitely win this one.
Give me the
bat. If you get a baddie, you get a kick.
For 30. Yes, sir. Nicely done by Regis. Where's the sand trap?
I've never been married.
On to the part 3. A little bit of a downhill. 18 yards. They will play short course. It's not for any point, it's just for a bragging race. And after anthem play. Maybe a little bit less. Sometimes when you're second, you know what your opponent does.
Well, I like it.
10 feet. Regis actually cannot put it in. He has to hope that Tebow fucks up. As he was within 10 feet.
I just love winning.
To give America 2 straight wins.
He will.
It's Tebow. Head spinning. Regis is out.
Thank you for coming.
Okay, so we got a big first round match between Maya and Mel in this competition. Mel got stumped in a playoff hole against Baby. The Meltic got stumped from Maya and ended up winning the tournament last time. So she's in the Supercross for 2018 automatically, of course, because she won an event. So she'll have to wait 11 months to try to get that Supercross tournament. I think she did well last year. She got to the semifinals. Yeah, obviously you're not going to get. So they're going to basically, this part 5 basically means you have to lay up on your second shot. But pray that you hit like a second shot. Now he's on the fairway. It is a part 5, so you can have a little bit of leeway. Okay. Oh. Black at rock. Oh. A little too much on that. A little too much. Mel's got an opportunity to play the bump and run. Booyah. Oh yeah, he did. Maya will putt too. Yeah, I would putt too. I would putt with the big cup. I would putt. But she missed. Tapping, no. Yeah. Mel knew what he was doing with the bump and run. Maya probably would have done better, but she put a little too much food on it. The island. And I believe they'll probably just throw 3 woods. That's a smart thing to do, is not for distance. Just for the fact that you gotta set up your second shot. I don't know if Maya's got a good angle or not. Let's see. And she will be on the green, but she's an area code away, if you will. Now it's gonna flip up far. And he's close. He's very close.
Birdies are your friends. Did it hard you?
I don't think she's gonna get it. Nope, she missed.
This could be awesome.
Now to give America 3 straight wins. He will. What a putting and Maya is eliminated right off the bat. Alright, so next up we got Renee and Camilla. Renee lost in the first round to Falcon. Camilla beat Louise, and then she couldn't beat Maya, so she only went to the second round of the tournament in January. Of course, we'll talk about the January tournament. We're headed to China Olympic style, which is US versus the world. Maya Renee doesn't know what she's doing. Of course, America has done pretty well for themselves to start this thing. Three straight wins by Americans. Now, of course, the format is America versus the world. So whoever gets the six first, whether the Americans or world players, will get the advantage. Then the other matches will be simulated, so I guess for the international, 6 feet. We might as well putt. Yes.
That ball is your enemy.
She's got to just put this down. Did you make this one? Renee would have won anyway. Man, America's just putting up massive numbers. This would be the fourth. So basically, the international player probably waiting on if you're playing. Chances are you might get in without having to face your opponents. So right now, America's got three winners out of three. Camilla's trying to avoid the internationals. Get destroyed. Let's see if Renee can check this one in.
Not
bad. And beat. Flip it up. The dominance for the Americans so far, so in the 10 holes, only one hole has been won by America, by a non-American.
Did you make this one?
Susan Mel.
Did you miss it? Did you lose?
Sweat. Regis did pull one back from T-Bone. Well, Camilla got close to the end, so she gets that hole. Camilla.
The last few seconds of your life.
Well, Regis would have played Sue. Now Camilla, if she wins, she takes on Sue because obviously it has to be U.S. world, so, and they'll go first. Not bad. Sometimes you gotta do that. You have to get a little bit less. Will Camilla finally give the international something to cheer about? Well, that's promising. That is promising because Renee did not hit
the
fairway for shot. That's not good. Where is she progressing? She'll go for it with a 6-iron. And trap. And she's gone. Yeah, she's basically out.
I hate losing!
Camilla, finally, an international golfer wins a match.
I won't look at you.
Alright, so another match. Americans have won three and Worlds have won one. This is the fifth match. And we've got Falcon and Fed. Falcon beat Renee before losing to Regis. Last Someone said that
the butt ended in my jack.
Hopefully Falcon can get past the brush. Whoa, that's 308. These two are actually long hitters, so it's not really going to affect them. Now, I screwed up. I said that Samala one was face 6. Nope, it did not hit Falcon. If it hit Falcon, he would have had to take a lower cloak. Not his pitching much. But anyway, it's going to go sharply to the left. Ooh. Literally off to the left. Then you can calm down and get on the green. Yes. Just under 10 feet. Falcon cannot technically put this one in. Yeah, he's been told.
Use the radar screen.
Yeah, he was told.
Is it hard, you?
You know he's going to put this one in. Yeah, they just won the second one. But anyway, Camelo will face T-Bone in the second round. So that looks like he'll probably win. Remember, it's 3-1 yet. They'll try to go for him too. And he's off the green, but he's in a good position. I dare say. Big match here. It will be, it's Ratchet and Emma taking each other on. The Americans are at 4-1 in the golf thing. Ratchet. Last tournament. Lost to Mishaki. Well, mostly because of the rain. The rain canceled the match. And it was Emma down T-Bone, which is not easy to do, but Lynn used the piss out of her. Let's see what Emma can do with the Niner. Not bad. But the wind is a little strong. Listen. I don't think Rax is going to... Yeah, that's the wind. It's broken. Did that work?
No.
No.
This time there's a birdie.
Whee! Not enough speed. Emma would have taken it.
That's okay.
Yes, sir.
Well, Emma got on the fairway when Ratchet didn't, so that's why she's got the lead. If Emma wins, just take on Mel, by the way. She'll be the second world golfer to win. Well, and bottle work. And here's Ratchet. Well, down the pike. Yeah. Do you really think she's going to win? Well, of course she will. Emma? Not bad. That's within 12 feet. So, well, I think she would be okay. Give it to me again. Here's Ratchet.
Yummy hamburger. You're better than a shoe.
Oh, he's going to be very close.
Wait.
5 feet. 8 feet.
You're the bird on the nest.
Well, let's see what Emma can do. Better not, because it's tournament length is hang on it.
Another one for two.
Yep, you got it. So now it's 1-1.
I don't like all these people.
Well, let's see. Ratchet wins. That's the fifth. He'll be the fifth American to win. If he loses, Emma will deal with Mel. You know, Camilla will fight Tito. Oh, wow. Stay safe, Emma. How did he botch that shot? Well, he hit the water. Well, that's not good. Emma will take the win. One for Ratchet. One for Ratchet. Alright, so this matchup has Louise versus Chaos. Louise got blown up by Camilla first round last tournament, so did Chaos. So these two are trying to... Someone will get a W under the weather might be turning almost unpleasant. Not so much, Chaos. Hit it that hard, but remember the old rule. If it hits the fairway, you're good. Mr. Dew.
Oh, we cut.
Ooh, no. Once I add a little bit more, it's a clear. That she didn't hit the sand trap. So technically, ooh, that's good. She'll have to fight, but Louise will win this hole. 1-1. She doesn't really have to put the shot in.
Finish him.
Obviously, he wants Louise to win. Now the question is, where do you go? Go left or right? Well, obviously, he's going to go left. They'll both take the left. I'm sorry. It's a scoop. Chaos. Flip it up.
Bonsai! Pull up sacred land!
Oh,
Your HSG. Your
life depends on this. Did it hard you?
Will I get it? Here you go. Beautiful.
He asked me to run, but he cheated with a long punch. Now,
well, another match. And the Worlds has done pretty well for themselves. They've added Louise, who will face Seuss in the second round. Now, a lot of people said, wait a minute, didn't Cal technically win that match against Louise? Well, he did, but he had to use a long putt to technically beat her. So, given the benefit of a doubt, they gave it to Louise. Well, it's mostly because the world's down 4-2. Ooh, Brad. Brad hit the floor.
Runway County last tournament beat Tiff. Beat Peavy. He actually
is the runner-up. Yeah, if I were him, I'd just take it easy, because knowing that wire could cost him So, anyway. Tony knows the lead.
Okay, so Louise will take on Seuss. Tony, if you win, he will take on...
Set. Yeah, he will take on Set, for sure.
I have to mention that Brad lost in a Pylino.
Alright, so our ninth matchup, we'll have Mike versus Sam. Mike lost in the first round to Maya. Sam beat Seuss before Jack got rid of him. Alright, let's see what happens here. We're on the fifth hole of the famous S-curve. Goes through down the pike. Oh, beautiful left. But Mike hit the water. He's like, how?
How deep?
Now, the first four matchups, we now two up in set. So, everyone's got the big question. Who's going to face who in the final two matchups of day number of Friday? Now remember, first to six wins, first to six, so we know that Lynn and Ellen got drawn as matchup number 12. Obviously they won't be playing, because their matchup will be decided by whichever gets to six first. I thought Sam was on the green. Got it. Ooh. Chance for Mike.
It's
puts it in. The tie. Going to match one. That job is just such a fact. You gotta go up and round. Took a big hop. It was literally under Sam's foot. So if it had been my Sam's foot, he would have had to take the club down.
Which could have been catastrophic.
I'm 33. What's farther? So what do I know? Silly. That's a good shot. He missed. Sam for the match. You got it. Yes, he does.
Uh-huh. Time for pot pie!
Indeed. Time for pot pie. Okay, matchup 10 has Jack versus Hubert. Jack last tournament took down Sid. Took down Sam. But before Misaki got to her. Before Misaki got to him. So, after last year's disastrous toll, he took it out. Hubert, on the other hand, beat Brad by Elena, but Misaki took him out. You're wondering about the top three from last year. Maya, Tony, and Misaki. Well, Misaki is the only one who has not gone yet. She's in the next matchup. But the thing is, Misaki might not get to the second one. Oh, wee. We have to put some more body English on that shot. Jack will be close. He almost sold it. Yeah, he'll put it. I mean, from 11 feet. He missed. See what Jack does. Misaki. Actually, Misaki might actually be rooting for Hubert Ross. Jack. The world is up 5-4 from Americans. If Jack wins, it's 5-5, which means Phoebe and Misaki will have to play. And that will be the last matchup of the day because some of them got the 6, make it 6-5, and then whoever. If Jack wins and Misaki wins her matchup, then Alan would actually get the benefit of the doubt and get the actual second round spot. Because if the 6-4 does, Alan would automatically can't win. If Jack wins and Phoebe wins, then Lynn would get into the next round. Alan would have to be devout because 6 Americans are ready. Ooh dear, how the hell did he put that one in? Oh, by the way, if anyone automatically gets in, totally fucked that one. I think Hewitt will knock it down. Well, I think basically he's going to give Jack the win, which will make it 6. We'll make it 5-5.
Shall I shine up the ball for you?
It will be 5-5.
And Jack will be
So our 11th matchup will see Phoebe and Misaki. Phoebe took care of Mel. Had a tough time against Tony, so she lost in the second round. Misaki. That's wise for someone to do that. Let's see what Phoebe can do. She's fine. And Misaki took second. Well, took third, excuse me, last turn with Maya and Tony winning. So she's trying to get back to the next round. Tony's actually won this match, whereas Maya lost her match. So basically, one and one. She let me start the other one. 145. Up and... over the hole. Took a gigantic bunny hop. We Saki, I know, will not make the same mistake.
The doctor was there.
It was bunny hopped, but it actually gave her... Well, Phoebe can actually cut it in because Misaki is more than 10 feet out. If she was less than 10 feet out, she's got it.
15 feet.
She's like...
This would be key for us.
14. If she was like 9 or 8 feet, then Phoebe could not get it in on purpose. Can Misaki put it in? Yes, she will. Nice win for Misaki.
So Misaki right now, she would win.
That actually helps Alan, because Alan would actually get... Alan would actually get the benefit of the doubt and face Misaki. I was about to say, oh no, God, no. She bottled it. No, she didn't. Yeah, so Misaki would face Alan. They would actually be third, right? Yes, they would be the... I've been told that it would be the third matchup on the Friday, because Alan has to basically play a match in an actual match. Like, they have to play it. They have to really play it. Misaki, she didn't bother with it, thank goodness. Well, let's see what Thieves does. Okay, so the both will have an up and over. Misaki's from 50. Up and over. That's not bad. That's within 5 feet. Phoebe's up and over from 38. Oh, look at... Oh, man. And then hadn't...
Don't pick at it.
Spun around the edge. That would have been a fantastic shot to win the match. No, sorry, to tie the match.
Hey,
Birdie.
This shot won't hurt a bit.
Ruby Saki's within 5 feet. I think she'll win this match.
Good.
It was closer. So she wins. Lynn and Alan, by acclamation,
will be in the match against Misaki. They'll go third on Friday.